Close your eyes. Spine straight, shoulders back. Hands resting on your knees. You can bring them up your legs, and that brings your shoulders back. Heart open. Slight tummy tuck. And then let your awareness return to the body and feel it right down to the ground. And rest awareness in the witnessing mode. Become the watcher. Not reactive, not caught up in the imagination or discursive thought. And rest here in what is sometimes called bare attention. Let your awareness rise up and fill the whole space of your body so that you are mindfully present throughout the entire field. Now, as you are quietly aware of this immediate experience of embodiment, set your body at ease, releasing any pent-up restrictions and tensions, be it in the shoulders, the neck, the face. Scan the body, relaxing every muscle. And relax especially the muscles of your face, the jaw, mouth. Relax the cheeks, forehead. Relax the eyes. Fall back deeply into their sockets, which sets your whole body at ease. And especially with every out-breath, there is a natural occasion of letting go of all tension in face and in body. Scan your body. Let it be still, but with a posture of vigilance. Spine straight, shoulders back, heart open. Slight relaxed tuck of the tummy. A posture of vigilance. Feel your breath as it goes in and then out. Feel as the abdomen expands and relaxes. All the way in, all the way out. settle the body into its natural state of relaxation, stillness, and vigilance. So on this basis, settle your speech in effortless silence, that mental chit-chat, and we move on to speech by focusing on the breath. So attend closely to the breath. Focus all attention on the breath, while at the same time relinquish all control. Go. The key is the out breath, so releasing more and more deeply with every breath, utterly release the breath, and along with this, release all thoughts of past and future, any memories, any worries, just let them go. Rest in the present moment awareness of the breath. Enjoy a refuge of retreat from the ongoing drone of rumination. Even deeply, and take the out breath to its very end, and let this be a time of total trust that you can totally release the breath, giving it away to the very last scent until there's nothing left. Then, without any need to exert yourself, after releasing all your out breath, and let the in-breath flow naturally in of its own accord. Received but not taken. Be content with what is received. Trust your body, just as the heart pumps within the body and maintains itself without us. The body is very good at breathing. And just get out of the way. Deepen the relaxation with the out-breath. Then with the in-breath, brighten your awareness of the sensations of the field of the body. So relax even deeper with every out-breath. And brighten your awareness with the in-breath. Deepen and relax, and brighten with the end. will begin to notice a synergy of settling the body and the breath into their natural states, one deepening the other. Deepen the breath, relax. Now deliberately allow yourself to put on hold all concerns of future and past. Give yourself a break and allow yourself to rest in the present moment. Non-discursively, non-conceptually. Focusing on the breath, release all stories of past and future. Any memories or fears or worries. Let them go and rest in the present moment. Once in a while, scanning the body, making sure that your spine is straight, shoulders back, body relaxed, face relaxed, and then go back to the breath. Relaxing more deeply with every out-breath. And bringing awareness with the in-breath. And for the remainder of the session, focus your attention to the entire space of the body, the entire field, and not any one part. Turn attention away from the five senses and ground awareness, focusing especially on the sensations of the in and the out breath as they most distinctly manifest in this field. Relax out and brighten awareness on the in breath. This requires a flow of recollection of present moment awareness. So let any distractions flow off of you. Maintain a flow of knowing the sensations of the breath. Monitor the breath. And as we attend to the flow of the breath, ask, how is the mind moving? How is it being stimulated? And then let the mind rest in the neutral place of the breath and in its present moment awareness. Here we are cultivating attentional balance, which includes ease, stability, and clarity. For this session, we focus on relaxation, settling the mind at ease, relaxing more deeply with every out-breath. Breathe in and brighten awareness. Even at this early phase, there is an element of balance, relaxing deeply, but balance lies in sustaining the mental acuity and clarity. It's rather like falling asleep lucidly. So relax back, but stay aware. Wanders, just bring it back. Now and again, check out in the body, especially the eyes, the muscles around the eyes, and settle your body into its natural state again. Okay, slowly come back to your body. Feel the seat below you, the air on your skin, the room around you. And when you're ready, you can slowly open your eyes. Thank you. stretch or twist if you have to. Face down or up, gently forward. Jaw parallel to the ground. Loose, relaxed. Eyes melted deep into their sockets. Expanse of space between your breaths. In this way, let your awareness descend into the body, letting the awareness permeate the body, settling it into its natural state. Relax deeply, further with each out breath. Just be here now. Relaxing on the out breath. Breathing in bright vigilance. Settle your mind at ease. Stay in this silence, in this stillness. Like a flash of lightning that illuminates the entire sky, let your awareness illuminate the whole space of your body. No need to visualize it or cognize it. Just be aware. Be aware of the sensations that rise up to meet you. So again, you're taking that watcher state of mind. And letting the awareness and these sensations not be your sensations, but be sensations that cross the field of your mind. Just watch. Now let's further enhance the attentional skills to include vividness. And the one that lends itself best is the sensation of the breath as it goes in and as it goes out. Distinctly focus on the aperture of the nose, the two nostrils. The point where the nostrils meet that upper lip, right at the entrance, right there. Elevating our attention from just breath, then to the sensations of breath. To the sensations at the aperture of the nose. Now it's very important to keep your eyes soft, unfocused. All the muscles around the eyes have to be relaxed. Your forehead spacious. Disengage from the visual perceptions that you normally associate with your eyes for watching. Watching without using your eyes. Watching that breath and the sensations that arise at the aperture of the nose as the breath goes out and as it comes in. Nothing else in the world exists but this, here now. See as the breath flows naturally. Trying to control it. It's not even your breath, it's just breath, and you're watching. As the breath flows out, deeply relax while gently sustaining the flow of mindfulness to focus on the ongoing flow of the breath. Arouse and relax with each full cycle. now as with a child. We'll apply a little bit more discipline, always in a gentle way, but a bit more discipline nonetheless. The task now is to subdue the obsessive flow of thoughts so that you can finally have some peace and quiet. Thin out the flow of your thoughts. Replace the random thoughts with the few regular thoughts which have to do with your breath. Its flow, the sensations at your nostrils as it flows in, and you relax and you breathe out and you brighten. And sometimes our minds don't want to cooperate. Those obsessive ruminations keep rising up to the forefront. So we're going to insert still another regular thought. And it's going to come by way of counting. Counting the breath. Not controlling it. You're still just watching it. Not counting your breath. Just counting breath. So at the end of the inhalation, just before the exhalation, mentally count 1. Like a road mark. Very quiet, non-conceptual, still attending to the sensations of the breath. Relaxed. Quietly arouse your attention as the breath goes in. And right before the exhalation, count 2. In between counts, stay quiet. The whole process is very quiet. So in this way, see if you can't count to 10. At the end of the inhalation, counting, placing the road mark, and then exhale. distracting to recall which number you're on because you're so in the moment. You can keep saying one. That's okay. It's just a road mark at the end of the inhalation. See that your focus stays on the mindfulness of the sensations of the breath and not so much the counting. The counting again is just a road mark. To focus on the counting is to lose the whole point. The only point of the road mark is to insert a chosen thought to break up those ruminations we get caught up in. So far, as we've been exercising and refining our faculty of attention, this is mindfulness. Sustaining the ongoing flow of non-forgetfulness. A continual engagement with a chosen object. When the mind gets distracted, bring it gently back. And maybe at this point you're even slipping down into that slippery slope of sleep. So be sure on the inhale to brighten your mind, brighten your attention. Focus on the sensations of the breath at the aperture of the nose, as it is the most important thing in the world. Constantly checking your mind, inserting those roadmaps to keep the attention strong. Relax, release, return, anytime an unwanted thought enters. Even if you pass 10, just keep going or start back at 1. If you do this well, your respiration settles more and more deeply. The flow becomes longer and thinner, finer. But you're just watching. The volume of the air decreases through the nostrils as you go deeper. It enhances your acuity because your object is getting subtler and subtler, and your attention has to get stronger and stronger. In breath, place your road mark at the end. Exhale, relax. Keeping your attention on the sensations of the breath, at the aperture of the nose, brightly, in a very relaxed way. Keeping your attention on your mind. If there's any kind of excitation, unwanted thoughts, ruminations, again, relax, release, and return with more attention, more brightness to your object. release and return if you're off your object. Still inserting the thought of that road mark between the end of your in-breath and your exhale. Your object being the sensations of breath at the aperture of your nose. Relax, release, and return. Maybe your body is yelling at you. Maybe you're hungry. But can you let that emotion cross the sky of your mind and choose not to grab onto it? Can you choose to stay here now? Just a few more moments on your chosen object. Not just because the breath is necessarily something holy, but it's the intention behind it that's holy. Who you can become if you can learn to do this. How you can serve the world better if you can do this. If you can have a mind rather than being had by your mind. So give it one last go. Put your attention on your object. insert your road marks. Deepen your breath. Come back to your body and open your eyes. And congratulations. You did your hour and a half. So we'll take a lunch. Can you just come back in an hour? It's 12:50. It will be back at 1:50. Is that enough time? Yeah, okay. Good. That'll mean the talk will be a little shorter, but I think it's okay. I think it's better to have a little bit of